Hello everyone, so for this cake I am using ready cake mix. Why? Just because I've been in such a hurry, I've been so full of things in my schedule lately that I just wanted to ensure that this cake turned out okay. So one batter, I am splitting it into two sandwich tins, and I'm going to repeat the process because I need four of these layers for my cake. Now, as you can see, I am reusing these plastic silicone mats that were for the oven, and they started breaking, so I decided just to cut the shape and use this for my cake tins. So I just thought it's a good idea if you don't want to waste the mats that you have and they start breaking. Now, I do tend to use my microwave plates for cakes, just because I've always found it so much easier to do. I'm using ready-made icing. So here I'm putting the first base, and then to the second layer I'm making a small hole because I'm going to fill it up with some sweets. I do the same with the third one and then do some cream coat. Now, here's a small hack. I use the microwave plate and the little yeast that spins around in the microwave, and I just put it on a pot that I have, and it actually fits properly. And I just created my own turntable. So I don't know, it's a try and error, see if your microwave plate fits on any of the pots or pans that you have, and there you go. Now here I'm doing a cream coat, and the last part, as you can see, my cake was a little bit skewy because, well, I'm not professional and I don't have much equipment, so I'm just doing what I can with what I have. But it just proves that you can still come up with a good thought cake, which is full of love, and that's what's important in the end. Now, once this is done, I went ahead and put it in the freezer. Now, here it is. It's a huge block. Here's another piece that I also use because I can never get it flat enough. It always ends up sticking to my rolling pin, whatever I do. So I just go with what I know works, and I just need to flatten this a little bit more because the cake is taller than what this round is made for. So once I have that, I just go ahead and place it on top carefully. Now, this is the hardest part that I find. Just try to get the whole icing smooth. I do not achieve that. I do the best I can with the knowledge I have, with the time that I have. Just smooth it out with a little plastic where the icing comes wrapped, and I just pat it down. It takes forever to try to get it smooth, or as smooth as possible, but I want to think that it is pretty good. And now he starts the fun part because I'm going to start to decorate it. As you saw, I put some of those Smarties, which are Megan's favorite sweets, and I'm going to use a waffle cone and one of these Terry chocolate oranges as the ice cream. But because that chocolate ball is actually quite heavy, I don't want the cake to sink once it's defrosted. So I'm going to use like a piece of wooden rod, which I cut at the same level of the cake, and I'm going to put that in the middle as best as I can. Remember, all the Smarties are inside, so it might be a little bit of wiggling, but just do the best you can. Now, if you ask me, I tend to wash this rod and dry it thoroughly and reuse it as many times as I can, so I don't have to keep buying this. Of course, once it goes a little bit icky, then I'll just chuck it in the compost. Now, here I'm cutting some cooking chocolate blocks because I'm going to put them in the microwave. In total, I did 1.5 packs of chocolate blocks. And it's white because Megan's favorite ice cream is strawberry, so I'm going to turn it pink. And I end up putting quite a lot of this dye just to make sure that it turned pink. I don't know why is it that I can never get it very deep color. So anyway, here it is. I'm using a spoon to tip some of that to make it look like the ice cream just fell off and is melting there. And now for the chocolate ball. Ideally, if you can, maybe wait a little bit until the chocolate starts to set a little bit more. I didn't wait that long. I put the chocolate and it worked, but eventually I could have done with probably a second coat or maybe a third one, because the chocolate eventually started coming, looking a little bit dark, not quite pink. So if you wanted to look super pink, you probably want to do triple coats, or maybe just wait for the chocolate to set a little bit. And now you need to try to smooth out the chocolate as fast as you can, because obviously the cake is frozen, so the chocolate starts to set very fast once it's there. And then just put some sprinkles to resemble the sprinkles that you normally get on a cone. And then just put the candle. As you can see, there's a small hole at the back in between the cone, which I prefer, as you can see here, once the chocolate was setting. Here it is. It's not perfect, but it did a trick and my little one really enjoyed it. So I really hope that you give this a go. It was quite fun to make and actually very tasty. Perhaps because of the amount of sugar is in this thing. Well, for what it cost, which was about £20, it's actually very good. I mean, have you seen these cakes online? If you are looking for a professional finish, you are looking probably about £80 per cake like this. So it's not bad. You get to do it yourself, you enjoy the process, and you get to see the faces of your little ones when they're actually cutting into the cake, or if you cut into a cake for them. I'll see you in my next video. Until then, stay strong, healthy, and happy.